Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to Gamestah's coverage of the ESEA Australian Open. Light up. My name is Gamestah Neba, and we'll be bringing you the game on Inferno, which is ELIM Gaming versus the Mediocre 5. But once again, joining me in the Gamestah studio is the one, the only, the man of a thousand voices. It is Mr. Daz on PC. Welcome back to the Gamestah studio.
Hey, what's going on? I'm ready here for another crazy matchup here on DE Inferno. We're gonna see how the knife round plays out here.
Not just yet. ELIM don't actually have all five in yet. But look, he's the man. He's got the Peter Griffin. I'm sure we'll probably hear more from him or some.
I think we'll need
some, maybe some other experts maybe to come out in the future. Who knows? We'll see. But let's
maybe
go. Through...
David Attenborough needs to narrate the knife round.
I think so. Let's go through the team list very quickly for you. For Mediocre 5, we've got Mini, Zemp, Telm, Fuzzy, and Fox. For ELIM, we've got Farsho, Blitz, Ren, Ecstasy, and Ned. And take away that knife round, I do believe, Mr. Attenborough. I do believe that's what we're about to see.
As the knife round is now about to happen, they'll depict the teams from the end result. It's a five-man stack in mid, as the terrorists are aggressively rushing up, showing their finesse. As one is behind, and now they must deal with this as they stab down at Teal 9. Fox for the win, slashes Fasho. It's a complete slice up here. 2v2, and it's only EMP left, and he's gonna have to go, he's gonna get stabbed. The CTs, ELIM, definitely have choice of side.
Yes, they do, and look, if that doesn't get you pumped for a game of Counter-Strike, I don't know what will, but it looks like ELIM are going to be taking CT side here on Inferno. Mediocre 5 will be taking resident attacking duties here on the T side. Well done, sir. I've got to say, Mr. Attenborough, he certainly makes a knife round more enjoyable, I've got to say. But Daz, as we had some little bit of some issues there with our screen, guys, but... look, let's take it away here. Yeah, take it away here in round number one for me, Daz.
Okay, so it looks like we've got a bit of a stack up towards... smoke's gone down in middle from the counter-terrorists. They're going to be slow pushing up here. Nice shift walk up. Maybe some sort of a bus strategy over at jungle here. But we've got XTZ ready. The flashbang goes off, and they're going to be pushing through that smoke. A little bit of a tag up on there onto Fuzzy. And that's a huge play coming up from Fasho. He's going to come out of boy line, hit two on the head. Is it going to be a third? No way. He's able to escape with his life, and Blitz is going to take down Mini down in that jungle area. It's going to be a 2-on-4 situation here. XTC firing shots off. There's one in dig here underneath his truck, and Fox here up in the apartments is just going to go. Oh. But this frag is ridiculous here. What is going on?
Yeah, I don't know. It's a bit of a knifey, spoony, tit for tat. It's a lot of 1-for-1s, 1v1. It's Fox versus Ren, who's going to come off better. The bomb dropped down on top of truck. There's the decoy. Just trying to maybe psych each other out. The mind game's now being played. Ren does not want to peek too early. Spots it out. He unfortunately misses the shot. That's a good bomb pickup from Fox. Fakes the plant. Oh, probably could have gone for it.
39 seconds, and it looks like he's just going to hold it here behind this first box, and I think Ren knows it. He's going to go for this nice one-tap. Fox isn't moving. Oh, on the back and middle of sight. This is a good spot for a headshot with this Glock, but he's going to have to be careful here.
Oh, big shot. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Mediocre 5 take it. So as you saw on the scoreboard just as the knife round was going, Mediocre 5 are on how many wins? 3 wins and 2 losses, I do believe. And ELIM Gaming are currently sitting on 5-0. They are undefeated, so they are looking to continue their charge through the open ladder here, Daz. But Mediocre 5 showing, a good start to this match. And, it's going to be very interesting to see what they come up with here as the SMGs will now come out for the terrace so they can push pretty much wherever they want. An early scout buy from Fuzzy there.
Very interesting buy here coming out from the terrace, and it's going to work out with those SMGs. I didn't think it would, but it does, and now Banana's completely open. They do look like they've got a rotate coming in from XTC here. It's going to be with the CZ. Not going to be able to pick up too much there. A Zeus on Fox. I'm wondering if that was...
Oh my god! That is ridiculous!
That?
Fuzzy through the smoke onto Ecstasy.
Human reactions!
No...
What type of play was that?
No scoping through the... Smoke, are you kidding me, son? Get your Weet-Bix in your system, because he is going to be bowling them down. There we go, Mediocre 5. Wow, that is a huge start. And Fuzzy, that scout paying for itself here. Wow, that is
certainly
a ridiculous shot.
His this morning.
Oh mate, he's a 10 man. I tell you what, right now he rivals Brett Lee for his Weet-Bix. But you know, that is the start. If that doesn't give his side some kind of lift, I don't know what will. Mini with a big double kill. Fuzzy with a third. Ren actually team kills one, and now it's all up to this man. It is Farsho. He's in boiler. Spots out one, looking for anything. Oh, gets the delayed Kobe onto Fuzzy. Knocks him down there. But Mediocre 5-3. Very quick rounds, but here comes the first buy up for ELIM Gaming Jazz as we move into round 4 with 4 seconds.
And a very strong start there coming out from Mediocre 5. You can't ever count any sort of a team out at this sort of economic point in the game where you're able to get a full buy going. Fasho here, we see with that off over towards Banana. We're going to see what he's going to be able to pull out here. Just a bit of a stomp coming in the first 3 rounds. That's to be expected. Happens a lot in the high-level games just from that gun advantage.
Yeah, no, it's not like 3-0 is not necessarily anything. Normally the first round dictates the next two realistically. And you know, that's just unfortunately how it goes with the money, the economics of Counter-Strike, pretty much. You know, you need to save so you can actually have enough to maybe have a couple of repeat buys or even have a full buy with full utility. So, you know, that's just how it runs. But look, they've made the most of it. There's a 1-for-1 trade over on a jungle side. Ecstasy taking down Zemp before being traded by Fuzzy. He's traded faster than a pitcher who has no shoulders left. Tell him we'll grab one that's onto Blitz. And, wow, they are going to be... I don't know, they still want to work this A side. They've got to be very careful, though, because the CTs from ELIM are holding pretty strongly here, Daz.
You see Fasho over there still on that B site, watching it with the AWP. He's pretty fairly low here, so it looks like he's going to be... Oh, that's a nice pick from Ren out of that library. And Fuzzy knows it here. He's just going to cover it as his teammate Mini's going to plant open for mid, graveyard, pit, and Apsy. It's a good standard plant he's got going on, and Fasho's just going to be saving that AWP. Third round, it's unfortunate here. Not going to go for this. Looks like just saving coming out here from Fasho.
Yeah, this is week 6, so it is Inferno week, and Daz, as we've said on many caster before, is that, you know, Inferno tends to be a bit CT-sided. You know, they have to play a bit up, but if the T's can get any sort of decent, you know, push or positioning on the map, it forces the CT's into a very defensive, stagnant position. And that a lot of teams aren't necessarily good at those kind of back of sights and, like, knowing when to peek without being tagged themselves. So, Mediocre 5 certainly punishing ELIM Gaming at the moment. And it will be interesting to see if they go for a buy up here or if they're going to just... looks like they're going to save that AWP and go full utility on that AWP, but try and save up for next round.
Fasho's going to have to come up big here for ELIM. The rest of his team here on an eco. We see a smoke grenade and a flash on net. We'll see what he can do with that. But looks like it's going to be a solo here coming out from Fasho. He's going to put in a nice pre-nade if they do go for that Nana control. But they're just going up mid here. This is a good play from Mediocre 5 here. I like this. They got one watching the bridge here, one underneath barrel here in mid, just watching any sort of early...
Oh, wow! Fasho just got dropped with the pre-spam. I'm sorry, Daz, but that was a huge play. Mediocre 5 coming up absolutely large.
Oh, and look at that. Another spray down here. This is just methodical, calm picking play style here. They absolutely picked them apart. That's another refrag there from Ren, but Fuzzy is going to take him down. 5-0 on the board now for Mediocre 5. Strong start, T-side Inferno.
Yeah, look, Mediocre 5 showing that they are anything but at the moment. I mean, ELIM Gaming are undefeated. They have had a couple of easy wins, I will say, but I have had the pleasure of casting them in the past, so I do know that they are no pushovers. But, look, they are being made mincemeat out of right now by the boys from Mediocre 5. They've got to change things up. They're playing, it looks like they're trying to get a triple nade down to Nana right now. As we move into 1 minute and 37 seconds right now on the clock here in round number 6.
I'm concerned about this push up here. Look at this push coming in. Look at Fasho.
Yeah, they got a little very aggressive, and Fasho's coming around at the moment. He's going to be able to find Zemp's head, and he drops him down, and they are just closing the net. It is going to be Fuzzy. He's trapped in Nana. He could be shot from behind here if he's not careful. Flasho just putting that spam. They have to be careful because Fox is still trying to come through second mid. He's on hay bales trying to get in there at the moment. So we've got two interesting little battles going on at the moment. One here at crossover, one at the opening area. Flasho finally finds him, gets him with a good binkage. And Fox now is somehow trying to stay alive. I don't know if he should be staying in second mid. Maybe go into apartments here and try and hide for the next 45 seconds. But he's got four to beat here, Daz. Yeah, he's got four to beat, and he's in a very, very open position.
I mean, talking about that positioning, then coming into this round, they stacked up on Banana there, Mediocre 5, just up on Banana, and those almost looked like a triple molly coming out from Elim there, completely shutting down that B push. And I saw a little bit of a creep going up mid there. I believe that was from either Mini or Fuzzy. I believe it was Fuzzy pushing up the mid area. And the positioning coming in from, I believe it was Fasho out of carpet there, able to just peek up mid and shoot him in the back. And I think that comes down to Mediocre 5 just not a very good splitting strategy. Putting all of their eggs towards B maybe was their mistake in this round.
Yeah, Ned will find Fox there. He went searching. He found him. He missed the shot. And Elim get on the board here, finally showing to themselves that they could actually win rounds. And they did it pretty convincingly. They only lost one player. So their economy were doing pretty well right now, so they have full utility, full armor, nades, and an array of guns. But on the other side, Mediocre 5 have had some good rounds as well, and they are still not short of money. So we're going to see if Fasho can get anything. He gets one before being dropped by Tel9, and that's a one-for-one trade. Good trade, though. Actually, still picked up both AWPers. So now they're going to be pushing. It looks like that bomb could be playing Nana, but Fox playing very aggressively in apps here, Daz. Maybe trying to force a bit of an over-rotate.
Yeah, I think that's good.
Yeah.
He's getting that information play. He's got to be careful, though. Anyone could theoretically be in dark. Now, we know that he doesn't, so he's going to go in and check. Good play here coming out to get that intel. And if he knows they're not using the apartments, he's going to know there's going to be a defensive stance on the A and B bomb sites. Pretty easy to work out with four CT players remaining that they would split 2-on-2. But I like this defensive setups here. If you look on the radar, you can see the way they're positioned here. They can bomb site. Looking fairly strong from Elim Gaming. Blitz there ready. In a very tricky, awkward position here.
Yeah, and look, here they come. And the hold is being very good. Ecstasy grabbing one. Telm will grab another. Mini with a good return frags. They get the bomb planted. And it's now down to Ren and Ned. Great name, Ned. Fucking love it. And he's going to have to try and the two versus one. He should be able to get it. Ned with a good M4 spam and the defuse. Just too easy. Yep. Ned with a good
shot. Good on you, Ned.
Good on you, mate. That's a good name there. There's the round. And we'll double check. So we're about coming into the halfway point here. And Fox is actually leading the way. He's done very well. 9-4. And on the other side, Ned leading the way. Good old Neddy, 7-5. Elim Ned. So,
Neddy.
Yeah, he's doing very well for himself there. But Elim Gaming, they're working their way back in here, Daz. They've got a P90 for Ren. Getting up close and personal. Could see an aggressive push here up Nana or maybe through apps. Be very interesting to see where he takes it. But look at him,
He's taking Banana here. Hopefully he's going to be able to mow the lawn. He's going to take down one. Spray through the smoke. And that lawn almost mowed there.
A bit of a trim. He did very well. He pushed Nana. Did exactly what he needed to do. Try and get a kill. That would have been a good trade. Even if he only got one and traded, that still would have been a good information gathering. But he's still alive, so that P90 can be a very big use on that B-bomb site if they decide to push in there. So slowing the pace down just a little bit right now. And Elim Gaming looking a bit better now. They seem to have settled in a bit here in Mediocre 5. Actually seeming a bit more frantic at the moment. They don't seem to be as confident as they were the first five rounds pushing these sites.
I mean, you're seeing here Fuzzy, he was in mid, he was exposed to Balcony, he was exposed to Apps, he was exposed to mid. Three spots there. If Elim just got a little bit aggressive then, they could have caught out that bomb in mid and totally changed the course of this round. But now it's looking like it's going to be a 3-on-2, but that's a huge mowing the lawn moment.
Oh!
Ren picks it up. He's going to mow the lawn! Is he going to mow the lawn?
He got it again. and he decides to swap out the mower for the industrial strength blowback right now. That is the AK. He's now pushing hard. He wants one more. Can he get the four down? He wants the quad kill. Pushing around, he won't be able to get it. They've spotted him now. They know he's in second mid. Blitz will get him, but a big three down. Ren put that P90 to work. Did exactly what he needed to. Hold those choke points. Gave his side the start, and he's now going to swap it out for an AWP. The double AWP strategy now coming out for ELIM here. Quite popular on Inferno. One holds, obviously, the mid section. One holding the Nana section. So, look, the question is whether or not ELIM can make this work here, Daz.
5 rounds up here on the Terrace side. Mediocre 5 definitely looking in a good, strong position here. But they're on an eco, so we'll see what's happening here. Looks like they're all up second mid here. Looks like it's going to be going for an A play. Slowly, though, not making any noise here. Hopefully, trying to catch these two AWPs off guard. If they can dig that AWP and pick it up, easily turn this round around. Buzzy here, playing a risky game up near Nani. He's going to put his back to jungle and run in, but his teammate's in boiler. It's all good. They've slipped past here. And this is good positioning they've got here. Let's see what they can do with it. An AWP over by Library. All they need is a bomb plant. And Blitz is in that pit area. They need to take him down quickly. And that's a huge play with the P250s. Three frags now. And they're all down. The bomb is down, Neva.
Yep, and it's an AWP and an AK is all that's remaining. So ELIM, I don't think they're going to push this here. I think they're just going to hold onto their weapons. And yes, they are. They're just going to run away. And look, that's very, very well done by the boys from Mediocre 5 to turn that pistol round into a winning round. And look, they pick up an M4 and an AK for their troubles here, Daz. That's, that's as good a round as you could hope for as a... look at that. They've even picked up the AWP now. They've picked up an AWP, one of the two AWPs, and they are going to be cheering.
I mean, it's very risky on an eco. If you're the buying team, it's very risky to peek these ecoing players, and you don't want to give them any sort of opening, because that's always what they're looking for. But I feel like if you're too passive, like we discussed before, they just left Diggity wide open. They left mid wide open. There was no one peeking from jungle. They just walked into that site. I believe ELIM just gave that to Mediocre.
Yeah, I think that was a round that realistically should not have gone the way it did. And look, ELIM really have no one to blame but themselves. However, you know, maybe they have a really good T side. I mean, they are down by 3, so at best now they can make it a 9-3. So Mediocre 5 will be very happy with their T half. I'm sure they'll want some more rounds, but even if they were to end the round, this half at 9-6, I think they'd still be feeling quite confident going into their CT half, Daz. They are very, very, very confident in themselves. I will say the pace of this match compared to a previous match we shoutcasted seems to be a bit slower. Both of these sides are not willing to rush. Both of these sides not really willing to push in unless they have information or with proper utility. And I think that's just something which, is kind of, a trademark of the higher end teams of this ESEA ladder.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be a thing. No chance is taken in the higher brackets. No one's going to be taking any silly gambles here, as they're blocked off by the Molly in a fairly awkward position. Fuzzy, I don't like this. I'd like to see him in boiler here or something, because that pick is inevitable coming in from the truck. And XTZ is going to take down Fox. Maybe a bit slow there in bad positioning, just hanging around in mid with 40 seconds left. Bit of a Na'Vi play, but ELIM have the numbers.
And those numbers are being dropped down right now, though. So look, Mini and Telm 9 grab one. They've got 26 seconds remaining on this half. They get the bomb down, though. So that's a very good work from Mediocre 5. They played very well. 2v2. The retakes. Here they come.
Me two favorites.
Midi, good old Neddy. Ren and Neddy. Neddy with a clutch. Oh, there's the reload. Ned's still got a peek. There's the double. There's the retake. The Ned Meister, he's done very well. And they have, look, Ned and Rent seem to be doing very well, Daz. From that retake position over near Library, they've done it twice now, and they'd be very, very happy with themselves getting that. And the economies from both sides actually right now, still an okay, I mean, Mediocre 5, if they were to lose this one now, maybe they could go a partial buy with some utility, but I think realistically this is a very important round. If ELIM win it, they will put themselves back within one, but if Mediocre 5 can win it, then they start to really get all these bonus rounds that, as a CT, you really don't want them to have.
I mean, talking about what you were saying before about how it's a trademark of high-level teams to, you know, be more passive, less aggressive, take less chances. I think when it comes to that, you've got such an even playing field between these two teams that I really believe that maybe sort of an IGL needs to start throwing out some wild calls. It all comes down to how each team is ran, you know, whether they're a five-man that communicates off each other or whether they have a designated one in-game leader. There's all kinds of factors that could be...
See, I think passive is maybe a wrong word. I think maybe calculated is a better word to give these teams. I think ELIM is very good at this. They're basically showing that they're looking for picks and they're not afraid to look for it. I mean, Fox in the last round picked up the opening frag on the A site. They thought the A site is open. Let's go. And, you know, for Mediocre 5. So they're, look, Mediocre 5 is doing it. And ELIM, again, I mean, Ren and Nettie didn't even look... They didn't push in unless it was together. So, you know, I honestly feel like that is what we're seeing right now, is that they're pushing together, they're trading well, and it's making for a really good game. So with 31 seconds right now, remaining 30 right now, Mediocre 5 got to make a move soon. This is going to be a very quick push.
Look at Ren. Look where he is. Oh, he's jumped down now. I was going to say, perfect. Lawn cutting position as he's going to take down one, but Mini is going to reply into that site, and that's just a trade into this site. And Ned coming up big for ELIM is going to shut that down. It's just Fox left, and he's going to be retreating 5 seconds. No way for a bomb plant. Unfortunate for Mediocre 5. Left it down to the key there. Such a Na'Vi style play I've noticed from Mediocre 5. Like you say, very calculated, but coming down to those bomb timers.
Those are very, very risky plays. I do understand why teams like to do them, but if you don't execute them correctly, they are a double-edged sword. You either get on and throw off your opposing side, but if they shut you down, you have no time for a rotate, no time to rework your strategy, and look, it's kind of an all-or-nothing roll of the dice, I guess you could call it. So, well done to ELIM there to pick up round number 5 into round number 12. We go with 1 minute and 39 seconds on the clock. Helm 9 will grab the first kill. That was onto Farsho up in the midsection. We're currently watching Fox. He was just doing a bit of spray at Taxi.
I have to comment on that. That molly they threw down on Fox, and you heard once again that damage sort of noise. And then the peak coming out from above those cinder bricks there at the front of car, just spraying Fox down at 2 HP. Very, very cluey play coming out from ELIM is what I've noticed.
Yeah, very, very well done by ELIM. Blitz now grabbing 3 kills at apartments. He was up on balcony, grabbed 2, dropped to pit, grabbed the final, and now we're watching Ecstasy. He spots up one more. Can Mini get anything? He's the last man remaining. He grabs Ecstasy. Good M4 spray, good control spray there, but he knows that he could be getting taken out very, very shortly if he's not careful with this one. So we have 46 seconds remaining now, and he's now playing apps, looking to come through boiler. Can he get one? No, he cannot, because Netty, the man. Good night, Ned, he says. And he drops him down. So well done to the boys from ELIM Gaming. They came from, let's have a quick look. They came from 5-0 back to 6 apiece. So they've done really well. Look at that graph. If we have a look at their total damage dealt. Mediocre 5 dealing a lot more damage than the boys from Ecstasy are right now, but the boys from ELIM, I should say, but ELIM is now, they're closing in. They've just gone a bit higher in terms of their total damage dealt.
That's
right now.
That's a huge spray down. You saw that.
Yeah, I did. I did have that. He sprayed up. I did have the graph over the top. I was trying to get out of it, but I accidentally clicked the tilde button, but Zemp with a really good, he's actually been quite quiet, I have to admit, even though he's, look, he's equal last, but he's had a bit of a quiet match here. Blitz, though, very, very aggressive. Will spot Telm, but Telm with a good Molotov there picks up Farsho over towards Boiler. But Mediocre 5 are now very aggressive once again, getting onto this site, and we'll get the bomb plant. That extra money is going to be a great help come later. Ned, once again, he's been very strong. Gets one, but there's a return frag. Now makes it a 1-3. Ecstasy grabs one. He's got 2 to go. Can he get any more here? Puts the incendiary at the back of sight and has to pick up the M4, but unfortunately he was caught with his pants around his ankles, and Fox drops him down. He's done very well. Fox has picked up 13 kills, Netty with 14 of his own. So they're on track. If they have a couple of big rounds here, they could hit that 20 bomb mark. But look, This is a very, very close game, Daz. I'd have to say, both of these teams, I'd have to rate them pretty similar to each other at the moment. Very, very close in skill rankings, and Mediocre 5 taking it to one of the undefeated teams here on the open ladder.
It's going to be at a crucial point here for ELIM. They really have to try and pick this eco up or get something out of it. Maybe get a few kills, maybe get some guns, damage the economy here of Mediocre 5. There's defensive smoke going down there towards Diggity, and it looks like Fox is going to be trying to be focusing on cutout. Just going to check it. Nothing there, and they're completely around Arch right now. And I'm pretty sure ELIM are aware of this, but that's a huge pickup there. Ned, bit too overzealous on the rotate, and Mini is going to pick up Ecstasy. And here, coming around, hopefully going to pick up another one of those mowing lawn plays as he picks up Fox with a fantastic headshot. And now he's got the AK and a chance at retaking on the safe bomb site.
Someone called Jim's Garden Services. We've got a couple of expert mowers here. I tell you what, right now, Mini and Zamp looking for them. But Telm with the final pickup. One and one and one. And Mediocre 5, they are going to be at in front come the half. With one round to go, can they pick one up? We'll see what kind of buy we get from ELIM here. They will go full buy up. Do they have full utility? A couple of only armors with no helmets. And, well, not full buy up, but look, as good as they can manage it versus five AKs. We do see a P90 once again with Fasho. So he's going to try and put a bit of work in that close range right now. And the CTs need to be very careful about how they play this one here, because being on less guns, or I guess you could say the worst guns, maybe, Daz. Look, you know, one pick can really open their sights.
Oh, and that's a huge, huge play from Mini. Absolute, I can't even comment on that. That was an insane flick there. He knew he was sandbagged. That was a double stack up there by ELIM. Close quarters at that B choke point. Maybe not the best decision to make, given the scoreboard at the moment. And Mini getting himself into this nice position here to pick up this surprise frag. The bomb's going down, but Ecstasy is going to take out two. He's taken his meds, and Mini's going to pick up Blitz. 1-2 situation. The Molly's going down. There's no way Mini should be able to pick this up. It's going to be a miracle if he's able to retake.
See if he can get this two. Well, he may not even get the bomb down. If he can just get the kills, 2v1 clutch coming up. He's got the M4 and 44 seconds remaining now to do it. So he's just got to take his time and hit those shots. They don't know where he is, and he's just being very careful. He picks one. Can he get it? No, he cannot. You work right, sir. Ecstasy spots him up. There's the half. 8-7. Well done to the boys from Mediocre 5. And, of course, they are 3-2, Mediocre 5, looking to go 4-2. But ELIM trying to keep their undefeated streak alive here. So, look, some very, very good halves there from both sides at the moment. Who would you be your early MVPs, Daz? Who do you reckon has been performing well?
Oh, to be honest, in the same way I'd say Get Right Forest combination, I think Ren and Ned are definitely that over on this ELIM side. Definitely a very entertaining pair to watch when they get into the scheme of things with their trade frags. Very, very high level plays coming out from them too, at least coming into this.
I think we also have to give Fox and his 5 ping. Surely someone's on the NBN, I tell you what. He's he's leading the way as we go live here in half number 2 for the Mediocre 5. So we'll see how big he goes. But ELIM Gaming start from one round behind. This could be anyone's game right now. And we'll see how ELIM
goes.
That's
a two man. And he's just abandoned him. Minnie's just leaving his teammate here. This could be dangerous here, Bert.
Yeah, it could be very, very dangerous. They pick up one Ecstasy with one Mini with the return frag. Picks him up and is now 4v4. So they've got a bit of work to do here, Daz. You know, they've got still got this. Oh, some good binkage from Mini. Whoa, the one tap with a USP.
That was amazing.
Oh, wow. That's exactly why, as a terrorist, the USP, you never buy the armor because the USP will just annihilate you if it gets you in the head. And that's where you should be aiming. So they need more utility here in Mediocre 5. Fuzzy doing a lot of work. Oh, Blitz, very well done. Picks up a double. That's the bomb plant. That's what you want as a T. The extra money will help you come into the next couple of rounds. Even if they lose this round right now, ELIM will be happy with themselves to get that extra money, Daz.
Oh, Ned, once again with a huge headshot through the box. Definitely one of my favorite players from this matchup due to the classical name. What is he doing? He's putting his back. One last remaining. That's why Fox on the site is going to pick up Ned, unfortunately. as I am gunning for ELIM Gaming here, but Fox is going to be shooting down behind this pillar. A bit of juking here with the USP and Glock.
He's got enough time. Does he have the kit? Yes, he does, and that should be the defuse. There it is. He'll get it. Yeah, we're just under a second to go. Gets it there. But look, ELIM will still be quite happy to have that money. The question is, do they save or do they go for a cheeky SMG buy? They are going to go full, not full eco, one flash and a Tech 9. So, and a couple of P250s there. So, look, a little bit of a cheeky... Yeah, I don't know. It looks like a little bit of a... And, well, look at that. The UMPs galore on the CT. So, Mediocre 5 looking to make a staple in this round. So, we'll see whether or not what they can do here.
And, mini last round, the huge USP shots. I think that was so significant. The way he was in that smoke, he's already picked up one. He left his teammate at Sandbags, went back, got a huge one tap based off of that timing of that peak. But to go back out on that smoke and find that extra headshot was a very ballsy play. He should have been picked up. That shouldn't have been Elin's round.
No, it shouldn't have been. But look, they made it
sorry,
work.
Sorry, midfire.
Yeah, sorry, you know what you mean, but they made it work. And look, the actual boys from ELIM actually having some good trades there, but Fasho just get caught in the reload. Fuzzy picking him up through library there with that P90, and Mediocre 5 once again opening up. They seem to be very strong at their pistol rounds, but I would have to say, in general, I think ELIM Gaming a bit stronger when they get the guns in hand. So one more full eco now coming out for ELIM. This should be 11 rounds to 7, you would think. But any frags are good frags, according to ELIM Gaming in this particular round. And we'll see where they start to push here. They start to look, they're gonna push pretty hard. Second mid here, Daz looking for something. And Zemp has played very, very well at apartments. He grabs one, Fuzzy grabs a double. Look at the second, Zemp with a double now, dropping them down very quickly. This is a very fast round. I do like what I'm seeing from ELIM here, trying to just do something and get anything, but it's not gonna work. Fox from the cutout position gets one. And now, there he is, Ned is caught in next to tree, next to the chicken pit, as it were.
A bit questionable.
Yeah, look, I don't, I honestly would have liked to have seen them all maybe just spam mid to diggity, probably, maybe buy a smoke and just try and get onto site, but look, that's why they're playing and I'm the caster.
Splitting against rifles. I think splitting against rifles like that, I think, I mean, they had an eco situation. Ned had the bomb up here at a T-stairs here, and they rushed through apps and just died. It was unfortunate going against those guns. I would have thought a Tech 9 choke point rush or some sort of more of a risk than a split. Very unlikely to succeed on a split with the gun disadvantage.
Yeah, they could have probably, I think, they could have easily have got a couple of kills out of that one as well. They just didn't seem to get them. So that's what's going to happen. When you look realistically, like you said, exactly right. They should have smoked off maybe Tech 9 choke point rush, maybe up through mid. They could have even gone Nana if they were really feeling ballsy. But look, that's enough about the last round anyway. But Fox looking for a shot, gets a lot of binkage and will hit Farsho as he just strafes out of Nana looking into that A-bomb site. Can't get anything with 1 minute and make that 58 seconds on the clock. And they're still working their way. I don't know, they don't really know. It looks like they want to push in through mid here, Daz. They want to work this crossover area. Whether or not they push jungle or diggity, they realistically should be flashing it, smoking it off here. We'll see where they go now. Here they come. Want to work diggity side. It would look... No, they're going to go jungle. Flashing over, looking for any kills. There's going to be one. Zemp will be dropped down. That's a big pickup. He's been very, very strong. Ren looking for another. There's the double from Ren. Ecstasy and Blitz follow him in. Blitz will get the headshot over the box in the center. And now there is only one man remaining. It is Fox. He's been strong, and he's just going to hide with that M4. He just... Well, Daz, I think, it's also Telm, I should say, but they're both hiding as well, so they know that they need to keep hold of these guns. But well done to ELIM to work that jungle side and work that bomb site.
They're going to be trying to save these weapons, but Ned's on the hunt. Excellent spot here from Fox. I do favor this spot. Very common, very known. It's even a good rotation spot, just a lurking spot as a terrorist. If you take that B site, or you just wrap around, Arch is definitely a good spot to pick up any sort of rotators. It's going to be 11-8 now. Mediocre 5 leading. But what are your predictions for this game?
Look, if well, in saying that, they're going toe to toe at the moment. Now, like you said, you like the ELIM boys, and I'm always a fan of the underdog. So I'm gonna call this one Mediocre 5, but I think it's going pretty close. I think it's gonna go 16-13 Mediocre 5 if they keep up this. But look, it's a seesaw battle at the moment. I mean, ELIM Gaming could easily come back into this one. They just need a couple of good rounds, force Mediocre 5. Look, they're not on a full buy up here, Daz. So, look, you know, ELIM 5 have, you could say, got a bit of the momentum with them. What about you? What do you reckon this game? How do you reckon this game's going?
Well, I reckon this game's good. Mini with the P250, the USP, let alone a P250 here. So, Fox does get taken down by Ecstasy. I wouldn't put him out of the round yet. I'm just very impressed by Mini at the moment. The level of skill I saw before.
Wow, Ecstasy through the smoke, picks up Fox. It's a really big pickup. That's going to force one to rotate back around into that Nana, that B bombsite area, and just makes it a little bit easier now for ELIM Gaming to push towards this mid site. Good step out by Zemp. He gets one, but Blitz from Boiler gets the return frag. They're trading well here. They have the one-man advantage, so they can use this to their liking. We'll see how they go now. And that's a very good decoy by Farsho over on that B bomb site. But here they come once again, working that jungle site. Fuzzy on site will be dropped down with Ecstasy, assisted by Blitz. Good AK spray from both of those men. And now looking for some more. Farsho gets one, has to check library here. That's a very good smoke off. And that bomb is ticking away. So ELIM Gaming going to come back in this one. Daz, I want to hear your prediction with 10 rounds remaining. Who do you reckon is going to come out of this one as we enter round number 21 and the third act of this match, if you will?
ELIM Gaming, to be honest, are looking pretty strong. I think they're looking pretty methodical, calm, slow. They like to clear out the angles, which is good to see. A lot of clue coming out from ELIM here. I want to see more out of Mini. That USP play, I know it was a couple of rounds ago, it was just so huge and was not meant to happen. If he just got Glock rushed, it would have been over.
Give me a score.
These sorts of plays coming out. Oh, I'm going to have to say...
Let's put your ESP to the test.
I'm going to have to say... See, I reckon this is going to be a close one. I'm going to say 16-13. I'm going to say 16-13 ELIM's way.
16-13 ELIM, all right. 16-13 Mediocre 5. We'll see which one of us is closer come game time. So 29 rounds it could go, but this is easily looking like it could go all 30 if this match keeps going. ELIM, it is very much a seesaw battle at the moment. Both of these sides not giving an inch, and they are doing very well, trading very well. Farsho gets one, and he finally gets dropped down by Telm. Good P250 work right now.
Mini.
Missing a couple, and now he's just being very, very dangerous at coils. That's great trading from ELIM. 3-for-1, and the bomb plant to boot. That's what they needed. Here comes Fuzzy. Needs to do something. Needs to get an initial pick. Can he get it? No, he cannot. Gets dropped down by Ren. He's done very well. And look, we haven't seen the Ren and Ned combination this half, but or I guess you could say Ren and Stimpy combo, I guess. Patent pending. So, ELIM Gaming bring that back to within one round, though. Mediocre 5 still in control a little bit, but look, this is a crucial round here, Daz. If they lose this one, they will be on the eco. So, ELIM Gaming will want to take advantage of this one. Full utility, full nades from both sides.
And you see Zemp there going to flash in mid. He's contemplating, or did contemplate peeking, but didn't peek, which is the smarter thing to do. Definitely don't want to peek terrorists on this map down mid. Very, very risky. Especially if one's in chicken pit, you can get your head taken off. Box. Yeah. Basho here. They got the man advantage over at Mediocre 5. Looks like a smoke that's going down a block CT. Ecstasy here is going to be smoking off. Now, this, I reckon, is going to be a fake. But Zemp picking up Ren, that is a crucial frag. That is going to put a thorn in Ecstasy's plans here with that fake smoke.
Even if they decide to go jungle, if they go now, they don't know Mini is currently sitting in the cutout in the little hole at the moment. So he could actually get a couple of frags, cheeky frags here if they don't actually check it. But it is 3-4. The CT still have that man advantage. So ELIM do not want to push.
Looks like they're going for a banana here.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to re-rotate back towards Nana. And I'm not 100% sure I agree with that. But look, yeah. But it is, they're going to make it work. It looks like he is. Who's that? That's Fox is rotating back over towards that A-bomb site. So they've picked right here. They've gambled. And now in come the mollies. And here come the nades. So in they go. Good smoke. It clears that choke point. Now they have to be careful. At the back of new box is going to be... Tell him with one. Can't get the second. Ecstasy and Ned. Good old Neddy will grab one. Ned with the bomb plant now. They've got the plant. They've got the money. Need to get the picks here. Ecstasy very well next to house. Ned, can he get this shot? There's going to be him and he's going to come face to face with Mini. Oh great flash. That is exactly what you want. That's the teamwork. Ecstasy with the flash into construction. Pops out and then drops him down. 11 rounds apiece. ELIM Gaming are now even with them once again here, Daz. And wow, they're going to be trying to take the lead for the first time in this match. And well, they've got the guns to do it. So that is a crucial round for ELIM Gaming.
I think that was very decisive there of ELIM Gaming on 40 seconds left on the clock. They got that pick up mid, a bit of a trade going towards Nana there. And they're shift walking up. Mediocre 5 had no idea it was going to be a B hit just from holding those shift keys there, not making that much noise, not giving away the game. But Zemp, another huge return. But Ren is again mowing the lawn.
There it is. Yeah.
Pick it up, making it 12-11.
Yeah, that's a good round there. Boys from Mediocre 5 did very well to actually pick up two frags there, forcing Ren and Ecstasy to rebuy up. But look at that. Ren, Ned and Ecstasy both on 10k plus money, and so was Blitz at that point. So look, they are in no shortage of funds at the moment, and well, they're going to be feeling very confident about this. Mediocre 5 looks strong, but the defensive half here doesn't seem as strong as their offensive half. And look, I guess we could say ELIM's offensive looking to be a little bit stronger than Mediocre 5.
I'm noticing both teams here seem to have the same sort of level of confidence. I don't really see any risky plays going on. That's a huge pickup there from Ren on Fox up into those apartments, I believe it was, unless I missed that one.
No, it was correct.
Boiler.
Into upstairs, yeah. He played very aggressively there.
Reckon they're going jungle?
No, I think they may go straight D. They seem to prefer this. They don't really like to push Diggity side here. They've got their nade strats to nade down... a library and connector, so they don't actually seem like they want to push that side. They really like doing the loop-de-loop around that side. And look, they've got sight once again. Ren will drop him down. That's the return frag onto Mini. Good trading. Still with that man advantage once again. They do have low HP, so Fuzzy and Telm could make this work if they get the opening pick, but they've got to play this one carefully. There is still that Molotov that can slow this push right down. And there it is. He's going to push that. Unfortunately, plays it right into the smoke. So, not going to get any burnage out of that. But look, they are going to run away right now. Fuzzy's actually coming back. Fuzzy's actually coming back. He came back for the gun. Came back for the AWP.
I think in situations like that, they have a chance to retake that. I mean, they didn't have the intel. Three players. How are they supposed to know that Fasho's on 13 HP? Understandable. But I don't reckon that ELIM Gaming knew they were both over there at jungle. If Teal was able to flash in there, they could have easily just ran in, slipped into the site, and just trade frag. Would have been a hard retake, but they could have got
it. Could actually be Teal 9. Make it Teal 9, but I don't think that's correct. I think it's Teal 9.
Teal 9? It's Teal M9.
Mate, I don't know.
Teal 9?
Mate, hit me up on Twitter. You've got that hashtag on the top right at hashtag Gamestah CSGO. Tell me how to actually pronounce your name so I can get it right next time. But there you go. So 13 rounds to 11. ELIM Gaming certainly looking better for Daz's prediction right now. So they're certainly doing very well. Fuzzy, though, gets a very good flash. He's now playing behind sandbags. They've got some great enforced spammage. Looking for some more. Fuzzy and Telm both go huge. There's two big kills for both of them. Ecstasy, the last man remaining. He's got the P90, he can do some P90 spammage, but, oh, he gets one. Picks up the AK.
Here we go. He can't miss that shot. That was a crucial
Look, he had the crosshair on just too low, needed a bit higher. Fox makes him pay, and 12 rounds to 13. Mediocre 5, look, they made them pay. They got a bit cocky there, Pushed a bit too aggressively and just, they just didn't nade out sandbags, and that's what happened. So, look, you know, they're still within this, and we are with one round. We've only got 5 rounds to play here, Daz, and our predictions looking like they could certainly come true. The question is, who will it be, or will we be right? That is the main question. So, look, great incendiary from Telm down to the bottom of Nana. Stops any kind of aggressive push from Ecstasy. Trying to nade him out at Car. Oh, they get
pretty far coming out. Lucky he didn't get tagged up by that nade. Ecstasy perfectly tucked behind that pillar there. It's going to go for a nice pop flash over to push them back. Smoke coming out, though. They need this control of Taxi. Mediocre 5. They don't want to let it go.
Yeah,
Fuzzy and Teal here, they don't want to let it go.
Yeah, they
that's a good choice.
Yeah, they don't want them to get too aggressive onto that B site, because it looks like Mediocre 5 seems to struggle a little bit just when they get onto site. Just a little bit. They've actually done pretty well, but ELIM just seem to hold sites better once they've got a hold of them. So once again, they're still not playing hard. Here come the nades out through mid now, and there's the sidestep. Ned grabs one. Fox drops him down. Some good trading. 2-for-2 trade at the moment. That's what they need to be seeing. Zempel grab Ren and makes it a 3-versus-3 situation. Now the bomb rotating onto B site. That is a very, very good rotate. Flasho now.
They're going to lose. ELIM's going to lose. They don't have the pair.
The Ren and Stimpy pair. Well, we'll see how they go. Flasho needs to put that bomb down soon, but they know that they're around. He gets dropped down. Telm with a great shot. Ecstasy and Blitz both pick up one. 1v1. Ecstasy needs to fake this. Yes, he does. Ooh. Double fake. Is it good enough? No, it's not. Zemp picks him up. 3 massive kills by Zemp. And we are locked once again at 13-13. So, wow. So, well, how many rounds have we got remaining? We've got 4 rounds to play. And we could be going to... We could be seeing one of the first draws that I've seen in a while. Because it is the open ladder. So, they don't actually play overtime as far as I'm aware. Look, we'll see when we get to that point. We've still got a couple rounds here, Daz. ELIM.
Oh, that was a ballsy peek.
Wow.
That was a risky play, and it's going to pay off. Very calculated to make that peek on the late game. ELIM not going to be expected that sort of a peek. I mean, they haven't done that all game, and now they pull it out now. It's such a crucial point. Gives testament to Mediocre's 5. I can't even speak today. Mediocre 5's blue.
They grabbed blue. They just grabbed 3... 2 big kills, 1 peak and 1 at boiler. ELIM now on the back foot once again. They are going to be forced to try and make something of this game, of this round, to get themselves a good position. They finally caught up and took the lead, but Mediocre just as fast, just took it back. Fuzzy just ate that nade, and Ned is still not convinced no one's back there, but he finally is told to come on. Grabs that bomb. He has to be careful about getting backstabbed here. There's the 1-for-1 trade. Zemp up at where it looks like he was up at graveyard. Fox from balcony, and Mini grabs the final kill, and wow, Mediocre 5 have hit the front once again. And wow, some desperate times now for ELIM. Oh, the tactical. The tactical pause. Let's have a quick look at the scoreboard. Zemp with 21, Fox FTW with 23, and 22 for Mini. On the other side of the board, Ecstasy has gone huge in the second half with 21, Daz. Ned, he stayed strong. He's probably been, we said we liked him because of his name, but he has actually been playing very, very strong in the second half. He's got 10 and 19 and 16, but Ren, have a look at how many assists he has. He has 5 assists for ELIM, so he may not be closing out a lot of kills, but he is certainly involved in a lot of them. So look, the tactical pause, Daz, I'm quite surprised to see it, but ELIM Gaming, actually kind of not surprising in a sense, mainly because they were up, and now they just lost the lead coming into the final 3 rounds of regulation.
Well, I think to be honest, they just need to reassess their strategy. You know, I think they need to cheer up a bit. I think they need to just, you know, keep their heads high, you know, not get too serious, not get too tense about it, so they're able to get that adrenaline out of their system if they have any at this lower level of a CGO Open ladder. Maybe they're new to playing
ESEA Open, not CG.
Ah.
So they all paid to be here. So look, you know,
they're very serious.
They're more serious than quite.
CGO.
Well, yeah, you would think so. Any time you have to pay to play in a competition, you'd think you'd want to put in a good showing. And I have to admit, both of these two teams are certainly giving us...
done exactly that.
Yeah, they're giving us a great game at the moment with three games. This is... you could split it, you know, either way right now. ELIM needs to change up something. And look, they are trying to get that opening frag. Zemp caught a bit... there. And now pushing, they're pushing hard, hard jungle, and it's working out for them right now. XTC grabs one, there's a return, Fox, some good M4 spray. Oh, he follows up with the pistol, finally getting dropped down, 2 for 2. Make that 2 for 3, Blitz, going huge, picks up two massive AK kills. Now they need that plant, it's going to be the open side next to Van, and they have the man advantage, M4 and UMP versus 3 AKs. Who's going to come off the better? ELIM, very important round to tie this one back up. That bomb ticking away. No time for saves right now. Mediocre 5, they should be going for this. And they are on site. Telm grabs one. Farsho with the double spray, you gun! Well done!
Ridiculous,
he clears
plays.
It.
Oh. And even
Jamie Oliver is impressed at that
play. Right, that was absolutely insane. They took the site, planted the bomb, and got in pit, and an excellent double spray down from Fasho there, showing us why ELIM truly are ready here. Yep. My prediction's going to be right. 16, what was my prediction? 16 what?
16, 13, so you're going to be wrong even if they do win, but still, they could win this game. But look, 14 apiece, two rounds of regulation. ELIM certainly would be very happy with that round. The tactical pause seems to have done the job here. So the question is, can they continue it once again? And look, a bit of an A side. Yeah, a bit of an A side stack. Oh, not an A side, jungle side stack, I should say. And here they go once again, pushing out jungle side.
Checking these angles, but is it going to be? Yes, he's going to pick up one into that graveyard area. Fine lurking around that diggity area to draw out anyone hiding on the site. And it looks like they've got a clean site apart from one hiding at the back there. And Fasho's going to deal with him. Going to be an easy pom plant here with 1 minute on the clock. Two rounds of Renee. Oh, Fuzzy from Library picking up one. Mateel a bit late on the rotate. And that's going to be awareness here or communication issue or something. And unless he can 1v3.
Oh, Neddy! Oh, man. Just drops him from behind Van. And ELIM have used the tactical pause to a T here, Daz. They have gone two rounds in a row and put themselves on match point. They have the guns. And it is a forced partial buy from Mediocre 5 right now. And wow, this could be game right now if ELIM can keep this. Yeah, look, they've just played it to perfection. It's not game over yet, but they have given themselves every chance to basically cause a bit of an upset here.
And just the way they baited them through jungle then and draw all the attention towards jungle as Fasho just goes over towards that diggity side to pick up that crucial frag in a graveyard. Like plays like that, obviously the tactical timeout working wonders here for ELIM Gaming.
Yeah, that I don't know what they said, but ELIM Gaming have certainly will be very happy with themselves. 1 minute and 20 seconds remaining in regulation. We've gone all 30. First kill is picked up by Telm. He gets the wall bang onto Fasho. That's a good pickup. But once again, here they come pushing jungle side. They have abused the boys on that side of the A bomb site. But are they going to back up here? It looked like they could back up and push Nana if they wanted to. But look, they are not taking any chances here, Daz. ELIM just spreading out, casting that net, and trying to get those picks once again, and before they push hard.
Surely, though, they should have known that crucial point upon the rotations. He could have gone all the way back to B, but it looks like they're hiding on the side.
Oh, wow! Ecstasy. Has he got it?
Ecstasy.
Are you kidding me, son?
He definitely has brought his drugs today, fellas.
He's got, it's 1v1 for the, this is for the ace. Ecstasy!
Oh my god.
Oh! Woo! The 5-down man clutch, are you kidding me? He has come in through balcony and he has just given the win to ELIM Gaming. Oh my god, what did we just see?
Ecstasy. How many caps has that player taken this morning? Huge plays, and the prediction I've put out, almost off by one round,
Wow.
Gaming that pick it up by the skin of their teeth.
Holy crap. Yeah, Daz, you are completely correct. And ELIM are going to move to 6 wins and 0 losses. Mediocre 5 will be 3-3 at the end of this one, and they will still be in that mid-pack. Certainly not out of it, but look, they've got... Oh, wow, they're going to be a bit heartbroken with them. They came so close to drawing that one back up, but Ecstasy just went huge, and he is going to be... look, he deserves all of the accolades there, and look, I have to admit... Wow, we still need to pick an MVP. We have to pick an MVP out of this game too, so I want to hear your thoughts first.
Oh, okay. I'm going to have to say, biasedly, Ecstasy, just for that play, just for the nature of that play. He was so low, he was about 4 HP, and he just 4K clutches the round on the site. That was just a beautiful play. His team would absolutely love that play.
Yep.
How could you not love that
1v,
play?
1v4 clutch, but a 5-man ace HP for the round. Yeah, so look, he was pretty close to the mid-pack, but I think as well he deserves it just given that play. It was a standout play. It allowed his side to actually get the win. And
definitely had his wheat mix and a rave in the morning, popping them MDMA caps as he's coming in.
So look, yeah, so we're going to give it to Ecstasy. He deserves it given that play. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to end the coverage for Week 6, the Inferno Week here. Before Gamestah, I'd like to thank my co-caster in crime, Mr. Daz on PC.
Thank you very much, Steve. I would like to thank you also for welcoming me to the team. My name could be Peter, or it could be not. But thank you for welcoming me to Gamestar, and I hope to offer some, you know, general analysis.
Yep, and look, we look forward to seeing a lot more of Daz in the future, guys. But from both me and Daz on PC, we'll see you next time here in the ESEA Open Ladder. Take care, good night.
Take care, fellas. Good night. The Elite Shoutcasting Network. Now,